Hello, it's Sunday the 22nd of January 2017. Now, you remember we were talking about certain tapes yesterday by celebrities, yes? Certain X tapes, yes. Well, don't be watching them on trains, dear. Oh, my word. Look at this in the paper this morning. Number of train passengers arrested for watching porn on their journeys. I didn't know you weren't allowed to do that. Why can't you watch it on your little screens? Oh, yes. The number of train passengers who have been arrested for watching pornography on trains has trebled in a year. It was revealed today. Police were called 26 times. 26. 26 times. Now, how many people get on the train? A little bit more than 26. I don't think that's bad at all. 26 times last year compared to a minuscule 17 times in 2015 after passengers noticed people watching explicit material on their smartphones and laptops. You can't make up. This is busybodies. Busybodies, you know, nosy people. I'd have the people arrested for looking at my mobile phone. How dare you look at my mobile phone and laptop? It's mine. If I was looking at that sort of thing on the trains. Earlier this week, the British Transport Police urged people who feel, and I quote, uncomfortable or distressed to contact them if they see those naughty old passengers watching porn. Dear me. A BT British Transport Police spokesman said, "We are aware that there has been some discussion in the media recently about people watching pornography on public transport and whether transport groups or the police can do anything about this. If you feel uncomfortable or distressed by someone who is looking at pornography on the railway, we want you to report it to us, for God's sake, man. Honestly, what is wrong with people? Stop looking at other people's phones then, you nosy people. What's wrong with you? God's sake. Of course, gang, you know, if you really want to be safe, if you really want to be safe on that train with no fear of being arrested whatsoever, you know what to watch, don't you? Hello, I provide an almost daily show for your entertainment, boys and girls. And so that you get it, perhaps you're on the train first thing in the morning, and I don't do one as early as that usually. What you could do is miss out tomorrow's show, okay? Miss out watching the show tomorrow, and then Tuesday morning, when you're on your way to work, there you are. You can watch it then. No worry about being arrested or quote, making people uncomfortable or distressed. Oh, diddums. Diddums. Oh, are you offended? Oh, you're offended, aren't you? You poor little thin-skinned thing. You're so terribly, terribly offended. God's sake, man. I mean, I think I would probably get a little bit uncomfortable if they had the sound up very high. You know. Oh, ah. Oh, dear. Some houses with very thin walls have that problem, don't they? Have you got a neighbour like that? Who makes those noises at night? Have you? Have you got thin walls? It makes it all the funnier when you know there's only one person living there, doesn't it? Oh dear, do be careful what you're watching on the trains, boys and girls. You naughty people. Now, I watched the... I've been to church this morning. Oh yes, I don't know how I go from porn to church, but there we are. I've been to church. My God, it was cold as I left this house on my push bike today. But I travelled through, boys and girls, I travelled through on the iced roads of the United Kingdom. I've got to say, it's a long time since I've seen ice and frost on the ground for a period of time, if you see what I mean. You know, we used to get this in the 70s. I think this is quite a cold January in comparison to what we've been having the last few years. Anyway, I made it there. And on the way back, I bumped into... What would you call a crowd of elderly people? A gaggle. A gaggle of elderly people were walking with sticks and things on the same path as I was cycling. I said, good morning, everyone. Honestly, the looks that they give you. You know, you think, why did I even bother? You know, because you're on the same path. The path is there for both people to share. Thank you very much. And yes, I can cycle on that particular path. Those of you do-gooders who are out there. But, oh, you shouldn't cycle on the path. Are you the same people that, oh, you shouldn't watch that sort of thing on the train. It distresses me. Well, look the other way. Dear me. And anyway, so I managed to get a smile out of a couple of them. But a couple of them, they look at you as if they were, you must die now. You know, you get that look. I got home, had a couple of bits of toast, and I've come up here to have a little chit-chat with you boys and girls. Last night, I was off last night. Actually, Danny, who's got the new job in Greg's, the baker's, was asking me last night that was I doing a live show, and I wasn't because I was doing all sorts of things last night. I don't schedule the live show. They happen as and when I find I've got time. You know, I'd like to say to you now, there might be a live show tonight, which there might be. But I can't guarantee it, so I don't. I'd rather not say it, rather than there will be a live show tonight. You know, there might be one tonight. Depends what I'm doing this evening. Okay, but last night I did quite a bit of clearing up last night. Actually, in my bedroom, get this, I pulled the bed away. Oh, the dust! The dust underneath that bed. A little bedside cabinet, pulled that away. Dust under there, with a Hoover. And then I got the sucky-sucky thing out, you know, that you attach to the Hoover and you do round the edges to suck up those little bits of dead dusts and probably a few insects in there as well. I like that word, insect. Insect. People eat insects, you know, in some countries. Oh, they dip them in all sorts of things and chocolate and what have you. What's all that about, eh? Anyway, so I done all my Hoovering last night in the bedroom, puffed up my feather mattress topper from John Lewis, which I know you, I must show you that one day. And then I went downstairs and I started chucking stuff away. Downstairs, what tends to happen is when I've got something made of material, a t-shirt, a towel, a sheet, whatever it is, it goes in a box for cat bedding. The thing is, this box is getting more and more, and I thought, this is ridiculous. You know, I only use about 6 items in there. So I chucked a load of that stuff away. I come back up to my cupboards and I chucked away old trainers because I've got some new trainers. I've got new trainers. Do you want to see them? Now, first of all, I have a limit to what I will pay on a pair of trainers. Now, these are from Polo from Ralph Lauren. Usual price, ding, about 110, 120 quid. There is no way I would pay that for a pair of trainers. My nephew would, 19. Oh, yes. Oh, it's an Adidas trainer. Oh, hang on. Oh, it's a new one. There's an extra dot on the side. Therefore, that's another £100. You know what they're like, these youngsters? They're all the same. All the same. Oh, nice. Everyone's wearing red trainers at the moment. Have you noticed that? The lads are all wearing red trainers at the moment. That must be the new fashion thing. But, you know, they bring out a trainer, like 100 quid, Adidas usually. They're very expensive, Adidas. About 100 quid. And then there will be a new stripe, just about an inch long, 2.5 centimetres for those of you who are foreign. About an inch long on the front there. Oh, that's a new design. Wow. Yep, that's a new design there. Those ones are £250. Oh, I can't wait to have a pair. My nephew's a bit like that. Not me. I wait for a sale. So I've got these Polo Ralph Lauren ones. I bought 2 pairs. Okay. These in the sale worked out at £51. Yes, £51. Now, here's one pair. Grey. Very good quality. Nice. Look, lovely. Grey. And to be in with the lads, here is my second pair of trainers. I haven't bought trainers for ages. I think I bought a pair last year that was in this sale as well. To be in with the lads, red trainers from Ralph Lauren. Again, £51. That's not bad, is it? Two pairs of trainers. So last night, I thought, let's have a bit of a clear out. And I have literally a bag in the spare room. Now, the spare room is, it's got to be 3 times the size of this. And ideally, I'd like to move all this into that room and we could have a big, great big studio, but it's a hell of a lot of effort. I mean, it really, I wouldn't be doing shows for 2 weeks while I was moving. There's wires and shelves and everything in here. So that's why I won't move it. Anyway, I got this bag of train in there and just chucked a lot away, all of them. All of them. I mean, some of them are years old. I have a real problem chucking stuff away. Do you? I hold on to this stuff. Oh, well, they're okay to walk up to the swimming pool in and that sort of thing. So I started off with those. Then it was the T-shirts. Chucked away a load of T-shirts that I haven't worn for years. Years. They sit there hanging in the cupboard, taking up space. There was some bedding, which has been washed and dried so many times that it's now it's now too small to go on the duvet. That you have to push that, you push this stuff in the duvet, and then when you shake it out, it's like lumpy because it's shrunk. I used to have a tumble dryer. It's probably the tumble dryer that shrunk all this stuff. I don't have a tumble dryer anymore. Two reasons for that. Number one, oh, they use a fortune in electricity. I can hear the meter going around. That meter is going round and round in that thing, so there's no tumble dryer here. And also, the other reason, it makes things shrink, and it makes things very thin. Very, very thin if they go into... Oh, maybe I should put myself in a tumble dryer. Just think how thin I will be. Oh, talking of thinness and fatness, congratulations to Adam the Plumber, who has joined... Oh, no, what's it called? Slimmer's Watch. Weightless people. Weight losing... Incorporated, something like that. Slimmer's World, maybe Slimmer's World. It might have been Slimmer's World. He's joined Slimmer's, and in a week, he's lost 4 pounds. Congratulations, Adam. Not an easy thing. I have great respect for people that try. It might not work, you know, you might find after a little while, oh, but it doesn't matter. You've tried. You've tried. So carry on with that, Adam. Very, very difficult to lose weight. I'm carrying an extra stone, maybe a stone and a half, I don't know. I'm definitely carrying an extra stone here, which I'd like to lose. And I keep falling off the wagon. Although yesterday, all I had extra was an extra bag of crisps. Great big bag it was. Family pack, which I had in between breakfast and lunch. Terrible. Terrible. But good news for the weight thing here. The last 2 nights after my evening meal, I've had nothing to eat. So evening meal, about 8 o'clock, and then nothing till the next morning. So I've made a little improvement here. So if I can keep that up for a few more nights, then that gets into you. Do you know what I mean? It gets into your head, and then you stop eating at night time. So that must be a good thing as well. Now, what was I just saying before that? Church, oh, I can't remember now. Have we finished that subject now? Oh, no, clearing out stuff. So, yes, bedding, that sort of thing. Chucked it all in the bin. And all done. And I put a new little, I change the cat's bedding every couple of days. And she put one down. I put some down last night for her. Went to church this morning, come back. She pooed in her bed. Oh, Katie. Although that is better than pooing on the floor, I must admit, because I just take it outside, shake it out in the bushes out there. And then that goes in a pile. I leave it outside the back door, actually. It goes in a little pile. When I got enough of it, I wash it all together and put another little bed down. So she's nice and comfortable. Now, did anyone see The Voice last night? Excellent, The Voice. I love The Voice. And there was this lad on there who sang beautifully. And they never turned round. On the other hand, he was more of a sort of opera singer type choir voice, you know what I mean? And I thought to myself, well, what would you do with someone like that? You know, they're trying to discover a pop star, aren't they? Well, he's not a pop star. Fantastic though he was, and I don't know if you saw it last night. I don't know what his name was. He was about 30 years old, black, and quite camp. Yes, not like me. Straight acting Chris. Pardon? He's very, very cab. I've got just a little clip of his voice. It's not brilliant quality because I recorded it off the telly. But have a listen to his voice. It's beautiful. Here we go. I'll move it on a bit. Hang on a minute. Oh, Here it comes, here it comes. Listen. Just beautiful. Absolutely stunning he was. And I couldn't find out what the song was called, so I put a request on the Facebook, and sure enough, people came back to me with the title of the tune, which I shall find. Yes, a few people came back with the title of the tune. Let's have a look there. Who was it? Jaden. Hello, Jaden. Jaden's a singer himself. And Jaden said it's called C-S-E from Cinema Paradiso. P-A-R-A-D-I-S-O. And just a beautiful, beautiful song. And Joanna also says, absolutely beautiful. It's C from Paradison with Song Heavenly. But they don't turn for that genre. Yeah, because none of the people turn around. And it's such a shame. You know, Tom Jones, there's Tom Jones. That girl from... Oh, what's her name now? Oh, Lord. Can't remember now. I'll come across the names in a minute. But I did put on there... they didn't turn around. And Mary, non-Irish Mary from Ireland, says he was wonderful. At least he's gotten some recognition now and will be picked for a show or label. I hope so, as in the Royal Operas. Well, I hope so. He should get a job with a song, with a voice like that. Beautiful. I'd love him to turn up at a karaoke and do that. I'll have to see if that song's available. That is such a beautiful song. Dawn, hello Dawn. Dawn Thorpe says, it's just stupid letting opera singers go on, as each time someone shows up, they never turn and just say, I wouldn't know what to do with them. And you're absolutely right, Dawn. But on the other hand, they wouldn't, would they? What can you do with someone? They're looking for a pop star. You're quite right. Why would you turn around for an opera singer? They're not looking for an opera singer. So I completely understand what you're saying there. Joanna says, I understand what you mean, Dawn, but it's true. When you're that good, the coaches really can't do anything for them. At least someone will see them and he will be recognised. Someone will be so grateful to have seen him and grab him. I could see him standing on massive stages or places like that, or in the Vatican. That would be lovely to have him in the Vatican singing like some sort of religious piece of music. Oh, just beautiful. Dawn also says, thing is, it's not about how good they are. It's about the genre of music. The coaches do nothing for them anyway, Dawn says. They will only see them for the 1 minute video clips that we see. I don't know how it all works, to be honest. I really don't. Jaden also says, they don't know what to do with classical. They told me that when I was in the last audition. So Jaden's obviously gone in for the voice as well, but not been picked because he does that, you know, like opera, must have gone in for an opera type song or something like that, that they're not looking for. And you do understand that the programme does have a certain format, doesn't it? I must say, I do love it. I absolutely love it. I really do love that programme. Charlie Hyde says, incredible talent. If they had changed midway through into a standard or pop tune, they would have had an idea of how to market him. How do you market someone like that? That's the thing. If at the end of his singing he has an album out, I would have bought that. I must admit, and I don't buy many albums now. I only buy like single tracks. You can get the single tracks now for like 99 pence generally. Amazon or hundreds of places, or you stream them, don't you? So that's it. I mean, just wonderful. What a shame that they didn't turn around for him there. Some messages on yesterday's show. Wendy says, you meant rebound for the quiz show yesterday. I'm not quite sure of what the quiz show was. We were talking yesterday about... this quiz show that was on Saturday morning. It was a bloke very immaculately dressed, but he just had no personality. You know, this is the host. No personality. And he was clearly reading from a script there. And when it came to talking to the contestants, there was just nothing there. But, you know, you can talk at someone and receive the answers, but there's no connect. Didn't seem to be any connection between the two of them. And yet these people get jobs. I just don't get it. Wendy says, did you mean Rebound? Don't know. Never watched it, but I think I know who you mean. Sean Fletcher. Ah, let's have a look. Let's see if I can find him and tell you if that's him or not. Fletcher. That's him. That's him. Yep, Sean Fletcher, absolutely immaculately dressed, drop-dead gorgeous. I wouldn't say no to him, but on the quiz show, I'm afraid no personality there. Wrong man for the job. Can we please dig up someone like Bog Monkhouse, who was the king of all chat show quiz show hosts, wasn't he? I love Bradley Walsh, says Wendy. Me too. Very natural. A great communicator. And when he's talking to his contestants on this show, can't remember what the quiz show's called, but he does a quiz show. And he's also, I think he did a talent show. Did he do a talent show? Maybe. That might have been someone else. But whenever he talks on the telly, it's like he's having a conversation with you, isn't it? Agree? Yeah. I love Bradley Walsh. He's hilarious. I'm the same in the morning. I was talking yesterday about don't talk to me before I've had a cup of tea in the morning. Wendy says, I'm the same. Nobody should try and have a conversation with me before I've had at least two mugs of Yorkshire tea. Da, 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 da. Just wanted to say congratulations to Danny Davis on his new job in Greg's the Bakers. Yeah, fabulous show quiz from yesterday. Thank you, Wendy. Simon says, on the subject of rude people, and we get them all the time, ruder and ruder and ruder. Correct, up here in Stoke, I do a joke at my karaoke and one of the said rude people turn around and say rudely, shut up and play the music. And I say, excuse me, I do not want the oil rag to argue when I'm talking to the mechanic, tar very much. And if it's music you want, pub down there does disco. This karaoke night, as said on the poster, give it back to him, I say, Mr. Chop Chop. I agree. Hello to Liam Farrell. Hello, Liam, whose birthday it was yesterday, who says, you can indeed make angel delight with soya milk. Yum, yum, yum. I'm going to get some. Next time I go shopping, I shall get some angel delight. Oh, strawberry flavour. Oh, vanilla. Vanilla's quite nice as well. Do you know, I'm actually tempted. It's early, isn't it? I'm actually tempted now to walk up to the supermarket, up to Sainsbury's, because that's the closest one to me, and get some angel delight. Although I bought a pizza from there yesterday. Very disappointing. I bought this pizza and it looks so lovely wrapped in this bit of cellophane. And I put it in the oven. I thought, well, that's going to be really delicious. I got it out. Well, where's the cheese? You know, it looked like it had a lot of cheese on it, but it came out of the oven. It was just all dough. I chucked half of it. It was a great big one. So I had half, you see, and I chucked half of it away completely. I just chucked the whole thing out. And the bit I had, I ended up scraping off what bits of cheese and a little bit of the top off and chucking most of the dough away. It was horrible. That pizza in Sainsbury's yesterday, so I shan't bother about that. But I might pop up there later and get some angel delights. Yum, yum. When I do that, actually, I'll film that. We'll do a cookery show. How to make angel delight with Chris Reardon. Yes, I like the sound of that. Good morning. Got to say good morning to Shania, and I've seen on the Facebook this morning, Shania, she's in bed, isn't she? She's in bed and she's been brought up dinner by her dad, Vectis Humphrey, into bed. Look, my God, how much is on that plate, woman? My God, look at it. She's got two great big sausages, although I must say, Vectis, did you cook that? I think you could have done those a little bit more, my dear. They're a little bit pink at the ends. You haven't turned them over, have you? Vectis, what have you done to those sausages, man? You've got to turn them over as you cook them. I can see pink bits around the outsides, dear. She's got two sausages, an egg, 1, 2, 3 slices of bacon, 2 potato waffles, a half a plate of baked beans, and some sort of, it looks like, is that half a pint of lager on her table? She's got it on one of those little tables with legs, which looks rather, I have to say, it does look, of course, I'm vegetarian, so I will have to have the Linda McCartney sausages, not the bits of dead animal that you've shoved on her plate, dear. My word. But she does look very happy with her breakfast. Although, actually, looking at the picture, has she had to come down to the kitchen to get that herself? What's going on there? So you've done her breakfast in bed and you never took it up, you lazy old git. Honestly, get up those stairs and take that breakfast up. I should have a word with him, Shania. How can you make someone breakfast in bed and then make them come downstairs to go and get it? The idea is you wake up and you eat. I couldn't do that. Oh, no. Breakfast in bed, or people eat biscuits in bed, don't they? Crumbs everywhere. Oh, how awful. Crumbs and bits of toast and what have you all over the place. Breakfast in bed, not for me. But I, can I suggest, Vectis, if you do want to do your lovely daughter, Shania, a breakfast in bed in future, can I suggest you take it up to her rather than make her come down and collect it? Lazy man you are. Let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Happy birthday this morning. One moment, please. Ah, to John Childe. 45 today. Where did you get to the other day, John? You left before your second song came on, didn't you, John? Dear me. Happy birthday, John. 45, one of our karaoke regulars. Michelle Jorgensen is 32 today. Happy birthday, Michelle. Ah, the lovely Mary Flick. Mary, Mary. I don't know any song's name with Mary in it. Mary, Mary, quite contrary. How does your garden grow? With silver bells and cockle shells and pretty maids all in a row. There we are. A Mary song. For, I mean, I know a lot of religious Mary songs, you know. If you want, I can do Ave, Ave, Ave Mary. I think it's Marie, is it? Or that might be Mari. Happy birthday, Mary. Happy birthday today to Adrian Grist. Adrian's birthday. To Sheriff Stuart is 32 years old today. Ah, Stuart Alistair Court. Happy birthday to you. To Lisa M. Kingswood. A lovely picture on your profile of the lovely Mr. Beans. And to very important person, owner, boys and girls, of the, not the cherry tree, of the Golden Lion in Sydenham, Gary Cummins. Today is 50 years old. Oh, come on, Gary. 50? A little bit more than that. I'm sure you're a little bit more than 50. Gary today is 50 years old. A very, very good friend of mine, Gary, who I worked with for several years, actually, first in the cherry tree and then in the Golden Lion in Sydenham. So happy birthday to you all, gang. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Now, I knew I'd be able to sing that good today because we did some wonderful hymns this morning in church. We did that one. We sent them to give the good news to the poor. Tell prisoners that they are prisoners no more. Tell blind people that they can see. And set the downtrodden free. And go tell it. Oh, you love that one, don't you? I knew you would. There we are. An extra bit of singing for you this morning at no additional cost to the people concerned. Marvellous. Now, we might be back a little bit later for a late night show this evening. Don't know. We'll see how it goes. No promises. Don't force me. Don't cage me. Don't put me in a cage and throw away the key. I don't want that to happen. Anyway, I'm going now. Enjoy your Sunday, boys and girls. Might see you a little bit later. If not, see you on the next show. Bye-bye now.